little floppy skin behind it is held tight. And everything goes back to drawing. As we draw, if we draw that in a floppy sort of way, then it's wrong. Good to say it's wrong. It has to be crisp, it has to be sharp, and it has to have that distinction. There's few things in the body where we can say this is absolutely sharp and crisp. But there's and the extensus is the longest muscle in the body. It's a long, strap-like muscle which comes way up here and sits in that valley there, up behind here, beside the chest, and zops down this. It's called the sartorius. Now, you're all intelligent people. Why would it be called the sartorius? Because the Latin for tailor is. You know, it's Taylor and Gloucester, they sat apparently on tables and so on. You know that. No, they sit there just. Okay, so what I'd like you to do now is to point your toe and lift as good. No, I'm going to lift it up to the edge of the long, straight distance across the feet. And they got across the edge of the feet. And they got to go. There it is, there, folks. Try the other leg.
And it really is doing that. I don't know if you guys are going to teach Louisa, glad to meet you. If you went to a primary school and you do this, if you ask the kids, what is that? You know, you do this, and they don't say to you many things. You know, you do this, it's going to happen to you. So that's what you're trying to figure. You want in against that simple and short answer, that running through the phrase, in yourself, you're default. So you have to be very cautious. That you may kind of say, that's what you want to kind of go back and find something that makes you ask a simple question, just like, we have a screen recording, 1, 2, 3, 2.5 heads tall, right there, and that one vertical, and then how down, how far down below. And building that off this one major edge right here. So when we start, you know, if you want to do a quick exercise, just to kind of understand this, what we're going to do is start off with the drawing, where first we only draw these vertical, and we take all the verticals that we can see around the model first, and see if we can take them all the way around, very light, just very, very light, take these things, and sense of how wide this is and how tall it is like this, before we put anything up. The next thing we come in, is we come in and we find what we think is like the major point. If I'm drawing this figure right now, and I have that vertical here, this vertical here, I think I would probably be finding that median as my major point. And then that would become my one. That one, that distance would become my one. And I would have all of it. And this would take place in about 3 to 5 minutes. It's not something, and I would do it in such a way that I could change it and let the drawing through. So that I would build that structure, that armature of the drawing first, and then come back in and start asking questions about, you know, where is the angle of that head? If that head is turned sideways, if that head is turned sideways like this, where are those eyes in relationship, nose, mouth, right here? Where is that angle in relationship to that angle of the neck? My question was, do I want to put it vertical or down? Before I even started to come in and draw the parts that would make me probably throw me over on the left-hand side of my brain. Okay. So if y'all want to, we can start. Maybe we'll put it in another vertical up behind it, that white box or something like that. We might be able to do a standing pose with just the box and move the chair if you could, and let you have those verticals to work on. I try to get the whole figure and try to get the whole figure on the whole thing. See if you can block that in. Do you don't have to drop everything in the you can leave things undone. You want to try to push your way into that process and away from the block. See. And then when we get that sort of armature built, then we come in and say, now, what is the value of what is happening here in this arm? How is that towards now? But let's focus on that armature first. And it's probably good to use charcoal pencils or something soft. You have bracers, something like that. Do they have rulers? Do you have any yardsticks or anything like that? Yeah, I would grab a ruler too, so I can make that line if we had a string, it would be great because you can measure the string really easy. If you're not just doing it one to one, if you draw this big, and you make this big, you can really change that. Let's see what happens when we start that.
Yeah, there's no need to wait and come back.
Yes,
interested.
Do you think it's important? 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 Do